Hello and welcome. Seven new Amazon SQS components are now available in Talent Studio version 6.3. This video will show you how to use these components to manage Amazon SQS queues and messages. To demonstrate this, we will create four simple jobs. The first job opens a connection to access Amazon Simple Queue service, then creates a new queue, finally lists all queues and displays the queue URLs on the console. The second job delivers a couple of messages to the new queue. The third job retrieves the delivered messages from the new queue and displays the messages and their attribute values on the console. The fourth job deletes the queue. Now let's start with the jobs. To save time, the components have already been configured. In the first job, the TSQS connection component opens a connection to access Simple Queue service. You need to specify the authentication information in the access key and secret key fields, and select the AWS region to be used from the region drop-down list. The TSQS queue create component creates a new queue named Talent. You need to select the use an existing connection checkbox to reuse the connection created by the TSQS connection component and enter the queue name in the queue field. The TSQS queue list component lists all queues in the region specified. It connects to the TIterateToFlow component via row iterate connection. The TIterateToFlow component then transforms the queue list into a data flow, edits the schema of the TIterateToFlow component by adding one column QURL to specify the QURL data passed onto the TLogRow component. The TLogRow component then displays the QURLs on the console. Now let's run the job. It's done, and you can see the queue URLs are successfully displayed on the console, including the URL for the newly created queue. You can also verify the result on SQS Management Console. In the second job, the TSQS output component delivers messages to the new queue talent. It is predefined with a single string column body, which holds the body of each message to be delivered, and another column create of string type is added. It indicates who creates the message. Note that in the QURL field, you can enter either the QURL or the queue name. The tfixed flow input component loads the messages and transfers them to the TSQS output component. Then let's run it. On SQS Management Console, you can view the messages to verify the job execution result. For the third job, the TSQS input component retrieves all messages from the new queue talent. It is predefined with the first four columns, and we add another five columns, which holds the values of four standard message attributes and one customized attribute creator. The delete the messages while streaming checkbox is selected, and the messages will be deleted after being retrieved. The TLogRow component displays the messages and the attributes values on the console. Now let's run the job. It's done. You can see the messages and their attribute values are displayed successfully on the console. Same as the previous job, you can verify the result on SQS Management Console. All messages are retrieved and deleted, and there is no message in the queue anymore. The first job is created with a standalone component TSQS queue delete, which will delete the queue talent. Okay, let's run it. It's done. You can see the queue has been deleted on SQS Management Console. Well, you can see it's very easy to manage Amazon SQS queues and messages with these new components. Please check out the other new feature videos in this series, as well as talent.com and our community site for more technical information. Thank you for watching.